You might be asking yourself, what is continuity editing? Continuity editing is a style of film editing and video editing in post-production process of filmmaking of narrative films and television programs. The purpose of continuity editing is to smooth over any inherent discontinuity of editing process and to establish a logical coherent between shots. So basically, this means that continuity editing is supposed to make the shots look as realistic as possible. Seamless editing is when your eyes follow the action without noticing that the shots have been cut together. Now this is why it's also called invisible editing, as we cannot see that the shots have been edited together. This can be seen in Griffith's work, The Birth of a Nation, released in 1915. Notice how all the shots blend together, like you can't really tell that the shots have been edited together. It follows through smoothly, like a story should. This technique is seen as mainstream today because what Griffith was doing back in the 1950s, it's still relevant today. Hollywood filmmakers adapted this in all their work to make sure that they were able to tell a story without the audience knowing that the edits have been cut together. A modern example of this is in this James Bond scene. Notice how you can't even tell that it's been edited together. This wasn't shot in all in one take, but it's been edited in a way that it follows through without any jitters, without any mistakes for you to identify that it has been edited together. So this is used in Hollywood films just to keep the story flowing and to make viewers think that they were watching something that's realistic. A motivated edit, or a motivated cut, as it's also known, is when a scene cuts to another scene or an object that was not there in the previous frame. This is done in a discreet manner so it does not seem confusing to the audience or break the illusion of continuity. The purpose of this motivated edit is usually to build suspense, show a conversation between characters, or even flashbacks. This is effective because it lets the audience know what is happening in the past. Motivated cuts is a part of continuity editing because if the series of shots is broken, kind of like the 180 degree rule, then the sequence of shots will no longer make sense. A modern example of motivated cuts is in the movie The Usual Suspects. In the opening scene of this movie, a motivated edit is used to create a flashback. This means the camera would not cut back to the previous scene or the edit that has been shown vaguely or not at all. This can be seen in early cinema in Griffith's film After Many Years, released in 1908. Showing a shipwrecked man and the woman he has left at home. Notice how the shots flick back and forth but still maintain the story and continuity.
And as you can see, I've point been of view is the shot 10 percentile
from the person's
JLB
point of view.
For the last
it is not used very often, but a program that uses it often
shit,
is
I'm losing
the program
him.
Peep Show. They use it to make you feel as if you're in the show, and it gives a different perspective of the show.
I like
show.
Going to the movies.
This interacts with the audience.
Everyone does.
Also,
man
it allows you to show,
woman must be interested
show
in film,
what the character
breathing
sees
oxygen,
and how they respond to things.
Converting protein intake into muscle energy.
Hi, guys.
Covered in the parking lot shot of the Nomad
shot.
Hotel and Casino.
Shot
Don, you can hear this from the hotel outside.
Talking to another character who is regular.
Changed lives for you.
Now,
you never had to wash another man's blood off.
Speak into the other character and then switch.
Took it out of your fingernails. You had us for that.
Speaking back at the person.
You ain't never made no real beef on your own.
Fourth looking type.
Shit as light in the ass as you are.
This was.
But you ain't never had to make nothing more than a fucking fish your whole life.
Ivy.
So if you think I'm gonna let your little punk
ass
get the dirt out of
me, listen to me.
Feel me off like a fucking field nigga.
You know I would.
Hand me to the feds like your last chip.
Whatever you think, whatever you listen to.
Your motherfucking mind.
If you.
Motherfucker!
Smoking aces. conversing with each other.
I've been trying to kill me!
Shots go back and forth as if there's a conversation.
I know, but you could do like a marriage comparison, you know, where Lee and Stan are a classic successful marriage and your parents are less classical.
That's true. I would love to be able to bring up the time they drove a car through the living room wall.
Cross-cut is a technique where two shots are taking place in two different locations, but it's edited so they are showing the audience that these events are taking place simultaneously. Cross-cutting is an alternative technique, as there are five different types of montage editing. The clip above from Inception uses one of the five types of montage. The montage technique used in this clip above is rhythmic editing. This is evident as in the clip, you can see that the shots were cutting from one shot to another in rhythm. Not only were they cut in rhythm, but they were also cutting from one shot to another at a fast pace. Doing this allows the drama to build, as it creates the purpose of creating tension and suspense, but also allows the audience to think. Transition. Jump cuts. An example of jump cuts is in a movie called Royal Tenenbaums. In the scene just before he kills himself, he's shown shaving his beard and cutting his hair. There's a jump cut here to reflect his emotions, to show that he is unsteady and that there is something wrong with him. You'll be able to see in the clip below, jump cuts was discovered by Méliès, also another person who used jump cuts as got up by discontinuity purposely to break the continuity. This is because they wanted to show that they were stylistic, and that reason still remains with contemporary filmmakers such as Tarantino and Nolan. Notice in the film Kill Bill that there is a slight continuity. This is to show the film look more artistic. At the same time, it's keeping
the audience still.